throughout its history, there's only been 7 band directors. I'm the 7th director in the 91 years here at Hastings College, which is pretty amazing. Most directors stay here for, I don't know, 10 to 15 years, and then they either retire or move on. But over that time period, we saw Dwayne Johnson taking the band program from Jimmy King and making it into a well-known touring band. So they started touring the state of Nebraska. During that time, also the Nebraska our Honors Festival was created. At that time, we were the only Honors Festival here in the state of Nebraska. So Wesleyan and Doane and the other colleges didn't have it at that time. So we had somewhere in the neighborhood of 600 to 700 auditions. We'd travel the state like we used to do, listening to live auditions, and then they would bring back a 70 to 80 piece honor band playing in Kiewit Gym like we still do to this day. So that kind of started that. And then our instrumental program grew from there. We added a jazz band. And then just the succession of directors took over, Tom O'Neill and Keith Ramsden, and a lot of these other guys just kind of refined already what Dwayne Johnson had built on. And then when I took over the band had seen some down years. And so we opened up the band to the whole community of Hastings College. And that's when we saw some really significant growth in the band.
The Hastings College Band is one of the largest student organizations on campus and performs at football games, parades, pep rallies, and concerts every year. The band began in 1924 with Horace M. Cunningham arriving on campus. He stated, "I'm looking forward to the day that we can own our own instruments, have uniforms, and play well enough to give a public concert." During the next couple of years, the band got just that. They were able to purchase uniforms and instruments. Dr. James King took over the band in 1929 and remained the director of the bands until 1967. During his time at Hastings College, the band began touring the state of Nebraska and became known as the granddaddy of Nebraskan touring bands. The band was also the first band to be broadcast live in the state of Nebraska in 1935.
And Jimmy King really put us on the map for instrumental music, and he was here for many, many years. He was one of the founding members of the Nebraska State Bandmasters Association. He really started getting us to form the marching band and the concert band and all those things, and really kind of put us on the map.
In 1945, because of World War II, the band suffered in numbers, causing Dr. James King to give a plea to any student who could play an instrument to join the band. The next year, the band was reorganized and started to grow. Only 4 short years later, the band and the campus as a whole suffered the loss of the chapel as a fire destroyed the building. The band had been utilizing the chapel as a rehearsal hall. The fire not only took the chapel, but also the 45 instruments inside. Through the succession of the next 4 band directors, the band continued to play on. In 1990, however, the band suffered yet another agonizing loss, as a fire in Fuhr Hall destroyed a lot of music and offices and closed it for the remainder of the semester. It didn't take long, however, to get Fuhr Hall back on its feet with a rededication. When Dr. Laing took over the band program in 2007, he saw the need for a separate ensemble that would have the ability to play at a higher level and possibly compete.
And then when I took over the band had seen some down years. And so we opened up the band to the whole community of Hastings College. And that's when we saw some really significant growth in the band. And then from that point, I decided I wanted to, we've always had the symphonic band. And then the symphonic band was kind of the only band that you played in. But I really wanted to have a competitive wind ensemble because that's a new, different experience for the students. So my first year here, I took the top 35 or 40 kids and we made the wind ensemble. And that first year was kind of rough because students had never played in an ensemble where, hey, I'm the only trumpet playing this part. It was kind of a new experience to them. And so over time, that ensemble really developed into the great ensemble that it is. And we took them to the state bandmasters convention a few years later. And then even to this day, the reputation of that ensemble is really, really good throughout the state. And then our symphonic band is, I tell people it's kind of the concert band version of our marching band, because everybody does marching band, but then we take the symphonic band and we do our concert ensemble, and having those wind ensemble kids in there and the symphonic band, you know, people in there really makes for a great ensemble to play some great literature and high quality literature.
Every year, band students make the trip back to campus a week early to go to band camp, a week filled with drills, sectionals, and fun.
Every year we get a great mix of students that come to Hastings College. I'm very fortunate that we get talented kids that come here, but some of them come in with no marching experience, and others come in with lots of marching experience. Some don't play their instrument really well, and others are all staters. And so it's my job to kind of pace that band camp and let the student leaders kind of lead that teaching of, you know, we gotta catch everybody up, and you know, it's gonna be fast, but we can't stress people out. So what I've done over the last couple of years is really empower the student leaders to do a lot of the teaching, because they've been there. They know what it's like to be a freshman.
Sophomore Jonathan Heredia became drum major at the beginning of the 2015-2016 school year and really wanted to bring some fun to band camp and to help the freshmen feel at home here at Hastings College.
It was his idea to add in the yoga and the dancing, but the rest, like the water balloon fight and all that fun stuff, really came from me and the section leaders. So we all came together, put our heads in, and we really want to make that as comfortable as possible for the freshmen coming in, because it's scary as a freshman. And so them coming in, you know, having a good time, getting to know each other, it really helps them out to like get comfortable around us. I really want to continue being drum major. It was a really fun year, and yeah, there's a couple things that could have been better, but like I'm only a sophomore, there's always room for improvement. And I really want the students to take charge. Because as Dr. Laing always says, that it's our band. So like adding a little more flashes here and there and all that couple of good stuff. So like making the students their own band. And I'm just there to help lead it, to make it their own.
Being in the band, you meet so many great, unique individuals. And so you're surrounded by smart, talented people. And I think being around that really kind of, I mean, to me, energizes me and wants me to work harder. So I think that helps out. I also think as the student gets older and more mature, and I hope they listen to the things I say in rehearsal, but I think that we do things so, I like to say methodically, I have a method to my madness, but we do things in such a way that the students will, by their fourth year or fifth year, that they've heard that stuff so much that it just becomes part of their routine.
For freshmen, the transition from high school to college is a hard one, especially when you have to quickly learn the ropes during band camp in time for the first performance at the end of the week. Freshman Carly Cremers plays the trumpet and is first chair. For her, moving to campus a week early for band camp was nerve-wracking.
I field marched once in my life for a band camp, and that was very difficult to me. And I was really nervous coming into this because it was so many older kids, and I figured everyone else would know how to field march, and then it'd be me going the opposite direction on the field and running into everybody. But it actually turned out really okay, because the whole band as a whole is just extremely chill and really nice. They work hard, but they don't take it to a level where they're just banging your head in, being like, do this right, and scaring you, and then you go to your dorm room and cry. No, it was actually a lot of fun. The whole first couple days of band camp were overall pretty overwhelming to me, because when I got the first part music for band, I kind of got shocked, because I was expecting to come in and be bottom of the totem pole and just be chill and work my way up, but then to have that high expectation of me the first time I came in. So when I went to field marching, I was like, I have to make sure to do this well, because obviously there are high expectations for me, and it was really nerve-wracking. But Jonathan and all the other helpers definitely assisted perfectly, and I got it down, and in no time I knew kind of what I was doing.
With the addition of fun activities during band camp, everyone gets to know each other very well, and in return, that reflects on the performances. For Carly and the other band members alike, the sense of community and unity within the band is very welcoming and encourages each member to play at their best.
Everybody is definitely so nice, and nobody's ever degrading about anything, and at first when I saw that first part music, I was like, what if everyone hates me now or something? I don't know how this works, but everyone's totally welcoming and they just want to help each other. And I feel like a little sister to everyone. And it's just so great because I can ask anybody in my section any question about life in general and they'll help, especially like Andrea and Nathan as section leaders. Like, they're just both great and they've helped me improve my trumpet playing a lot. And just from where I started coming into Hastings and where I am now already, I've increased like, whoosh, like with my trumpet skills, and it's super great and exciting.
Hastings College feels like home. I absolutely love it here. The professors here, they are amazing people, and you learn so much from them. And it just, like I said, it feels like home, and I just want to be here for a while. So I want to cherish the moments I have here left.
And just, I don't know, I feel like here there's like incredible possibilities for where my trumpet playing can go. Even though I'm not a music major, it can still be a huge part of my life, which I never would have guessed that it would continue being a part of my life, at least this big. I thought it was going to take a backseat to everything else I was doing, but now I see that it can stay up there and I'm actually enjoying it a lot more than I did in high school even.
I think what is great about the band is that we have such a collection of different personalities and different people. And to come together with different levels and different talent and to do what we do is an important, I mean, it's not just important, but it's an amazing process that happens. And I think it's education at its best. You take all these different things and they come together and make one cohesive performing unit.